Hello and welcome to my live coding session about my project Pocket Manager, which is a useful JavaFX application for managing XML files, which consist of satellite channels information. So, it took me a while, actually took me a lot of while, but I'm still working on my pet project. And I just want to show you recent update on my project. So basically my JavaFX application now consists of customized file chooser, which is my creation by any means. And it actually allow you to store a path for your JavaFX application, like the file, open XML files. Here you can pick your drive and then read from this edit field, and then you can use this information to actually load a file. And basically where I am going to, I need to make sure that I can populate the edit field with a file path, and I need to load only XML file which consists of satellite information, and then later I will after I loaded the file, I can actually start to populate the stuff. It will be pretty interesting. Currently I am at the moment where I just have written tests, and let me just quickly go quickly look it. Okay, so this test actually give you some sort of idea what I'm testing. So as user, you can input different kind of information through the file chooser. And here I have indirectly let me just think about, so here I'm just getting hold of a method which then populate the data in my main menu controller. Main menu controller will consist a list of file paths to the XMLs. So actually I can thinking about that I need to split some things from some classes from main menu controller, but I don't want to do that right at the moment. I just want to make sure that my file chooser works correctly. So how it works? Let me just quickly draw some picture on my favorite site tutorials point. I do not have any advertisement, but this is just rather useful site. And what I want to explain to you, that here I have my file main menu controller, and here I have my file chooser. So how it works? File chooser, let me just quickly write here file chooser. File chooser access main menu controller. Main menu controller. And writes data. What exactly he writes, it writes, this application writes file paths which consist of a path of one XML file per message. So here I'm drawing just a message. Main menu controller, it receives this file and verify that the input file order is OK. So for example, I have three cases. The first case, I just input one file after another, and Another case, I can import one and the same file, which is actually bad situation, but I know how to deal with it, and I deal with it in my code. Then I have the situation where I have more than three files, so I just managed to do that too. So basically my main controller having it produces a dialogs, like warning dialogs, if you put more than two equal files, or if you put one by one equal files, so one after another equal files, and if you try to put more than three files, then you will receive a warning dialog. So pretty actually, as description is simple stuff, but it took me a while to write it and test it out. I think I spent some hours, not 1 hour, some hours. And I think basically recently I worked in my freelance load as a freelancer. I'm most times currently working with the Angular and JavaScript based projects and not so much Java world. But I mean, if you learn Java at some point of time, you never forget it. So it's like getting your wheels spinning once again in the right direction. And so the first test, it actually do following. I have here a mockup, which consists, let me just quickly look up the method. This method populate this mockup. So you see three files. This is actually valid way to input the data. And it then verifies how did I get the order. So let me just execute this test. And you clearly see it works. And the output, debug output, looks like following. So this is what I get from my main menu controller. Amount of elements. So you see one iteration, second iteration, third iteration. This happens in my test which I showed to you. And the next test is a test where I input more than three files. So here I have the method. This method actually do the assertions. Click on menu file. I think you can read it. So more important stuff is, I think it is here. Let me just clear. Yeah. So here you see I have 1, 2, 3, 4 files, and this will be stored in this variable. And then I pass this variable to my method, write path custom file chooser, and just need to run my test. And then you can actually see how it goes. Now it populates the text input field once again. Another one, this is the third time. And then fourth time it's not allowed. So if the user tried to do that, he clicks, actually you saw the error warning message. So the next test is like following here, testing if user input one and the same file. It basically from the structure the same data structure. So I have here four files, but I will get a different kind of message. So basically I just get the message you as a user put one and the same file. So it will run through, let me just quickly look it up. It will run through this method, which iterate over the given list, over this list. And then you will, so it will get the yellow screen. Actually, it's a warning dialog, and let's just try to run, and then I conclude with running all of my tests. That you can see, it's still I have integrity in my test, so no test is compromised. And I gave you my afterthoughts about some interesting stuff which I discovered. So now it's just put one and the same file. You see it clearly. It's one and the same file. Oops. So first time it's okay, but if you put the same file name into this file chooser, it will give you some notification. And right now I just need to execute all of my test suites through POM run as Maven test. And let's just wait for running all of my stuff. It actually happens in the background. I'm still not to use that my Eclipse very new. I think I'm sort of early adapters in way of using of Eclipse. I always try to use the best tool for the best job. So I have can clearly see, for example, here IDEs. I have different kind of IDEs for different kind of jobs. So, but for my personal project, I prefer to use Eclipse. I think it just I got too used to it from my backwards when I studied in full time at my university. But you see clearly what just happened. It Maven get hold of different kind of repos. This did happen because I today deleted my repo. I mean the Maven temp repo locally, which locally stored at my PC, because I did experience some problems with my Eclipse IDE. I don't know why, but stuff can happen. I was pretty puzzled as the first time, but now you clearly see that I am running all of my tests. Now it's happening. Now you see UI tests, and this is works pretty cool. I can actually input some stuff, wrong file name, open and close windows, and licensing agreement. So it's basically running like pretty cool. And the point of test, each test should be run in random order and like independent from each other. Each unit test is independent from each other. So now you see I'm actually executing the test where I put, I think, one and the same file name. And my application verify and give you a notice. And this yellow notice, this warning screen, it clearly give you a message that if you put wrong files, it won't be stored at my program. So I need actually to store only valid files. And each time I verify if it is XML file or not. So pretty cool, I say. And this code will be available on GitHub as usual. I mean, my program is GPL licensed, so if you wish to use it, you can do it, but you need to share the code. It's like two side streets, and build succeeds. And what I have to say about afterthoughts, I discovered that TestFX have some issues. Let me just go back to my code. Okay, so actually I need my test. Make menu controller, not. Ah, here. So basically, I discovered that, let me show you the code part which I was quite puzzled. So here, this code actually do following. It verifies that the alert dialog is visible, and in JavaFX you have different kind of alert types. First, my idea was to invoke alert confirmation screen, but my test framework did not like it. I mean, it wasn't like not really supported. So I decided to use just simple warning message, and if we try to use some manual test, I'm actually not really like to use to do manual test. Let me just quickly do some stuff, and let me just quickly copy it. Just like I want to show you my screens which I have in my application. So if I run my application, here it is, Java application. Okay, so file, open XML file, input file. This will be like manual testing when a user put one and the same file. And you see, please load only three different files. Repeat loading of files again. All previously opened files were not loaded. So it basically say to you, better luck next time. So, and if user tried actually to do some different kind of files, I don't know. Let me just, like services, I have here different kind of services. Services, and then once again services, yeah. So it works pretty well, and the probably next thing is to do now I have reached the point, another milestone, where I know where my XML files are located, and I can load them into my application. So I mean, I'm actually probably will start to think about how to populate my UI from my Java objects. So basically, just need to close it. Basically, next move, let me just clear all. Now my UI, so my UI knows about, this is my UI. It stores three files, I mean three file paths, and I have written in the past all needed stuff to actually read from the given paths and then create objects for the given XML file. But the next move will be like populate all information to populate my UI and be able dynamically to represent the data. So I think this is actually huge, will be next huge milestone. And of course I will try to use TestFX. I'm not sure that TestFX will be able to handle all of needed steps, but still better than nothing. And actually stay tuned for this, and thank you for watching. One last mention, why it takes some time to write the code. I'm not fast coder. I always thinking about each method which I have written, and I'm taking a time to think about quality and the stability of my code. If you think about future and how fast and how long software can exist and can be actually used, you will be, I think you will, at some point of time, you will take care about what you do as a coder. I mean, sure, you have a pressure, you have a time schedule in the business world. I know it because I have a lot of experience in working in middle-sized companies, and I know how it looks like. But for my project, I take just time to do it right and to do it how I actually engineered in my thinking process. So everybody who wants to have pretty fast solution for the given task which I have taken upon, you cannot, I mean, I did got inquiries of people just saying, why don't you do it on the daily basis because you're working as a freelancer. But I say following, as a freelancer, I have some sort of a small amount of time to do such side projects. I do care about what I do as a freelancer for my clients, and I don't want to take too much overtime working on my side projects. So I think it's basically, on my side of you, it depends on my mood, my pretty in mood to do some programming job after spending a lot of times after my normal work. So keep I will say thank you for your time which you take to watch my videos, and I hope you learn something. I hope you see how it is possible to write a application in test-driven development manner. Currently, I have a proposal to people who saying test-driven development take so much time, we cannot do that. I say try to do it in projects where your iterations are already over time, overdue. And for the projects where you have big regulations, government regulations, I think it is possible too, but you need a support from your management and from your from your management staff, from your boss. Where TDD cannot be used pretty well, I will say, if you think about prototypes are products which just throw away products. Some consultancy companies actually doing such thing. So they have a client and they just write a prototype and say to client, look, we have a prototype. If you want it, we can develop a full established product. And some clients say, yeah, we'll do it. And some clients say, no, we don't. And if you working in such environment, I think that you won't get any profits if you try to write a prototype using TDD approach. And one last note, just for my personal reasons, in the Munich and conference OOP 2019, one company, Itaratech, I think, one guy, pretty senior developer, he presented like simplified presentation, and he described it that his team developed a fully functioning prototype, but without using any test-driven approach or supporting techniques. I think I'm pretty skeptical to the quality of such approach, but he assured me that his team was like crazy developers with more than 20 years. But still, I personally do not believe, and I want to reassure with this video that I think if you do such work, it is pretty risky, and even if you be able to have a fully functioning, working stably software, it is not for big amount of time. So at any given time where requirements will change, and they will change, such software will be not functioning properly because you did not care enough to verify the functionality of such software. So think, people, about this and decide upon yourself, make yourself look for the experience, not only from books but from actual projects. But I say test-driven development for me gives some sort of assurance that what I'm writing is actually happening, and this actually will be happening in production. So I would never ever get my software at such state where I have some conditions which actually not good, which actually not expected, but they can happen because of the nature of the engineering of the software. So I won't expect to see that in my project. And this is all from my side, and once again, thank you for watching this. Thank you, bye bye.